In this video, we have given that angle PQR is 110 degree, angle QRS is 130 degree, angle QPR is 35 degree, angle SPR is 30 degree, and angle RSQ is X. Then we have to find the value of X. So the first method, in triangle PQR, PQR, this angle is 110 degree, this angle is 35 degree, and suppose this angle is alpha, then 110 degree plus 35 degree plus alpha will be equal to 180 degree. That means alpha is equal to 35 degree. This angle is 35 degree. And now we have angle QPR is equal to angle QRP, that is 35 degree. That means QP will be equal to QR. QP will be equal to QR. And now angle SPR is 30 degree. So if we draw a perpendicular from R on PS, then in triangle PR, and suppose this point is M, in triangle PRM, PRM, this angle is 30 degree, this angle is 90 degree, so this angle will be 60 degree. And also sine 30 degree will be equal to RM by PR, and sine 30 degree is 1 by 2, that is equal to RM by PR. So we get RM is equal to PR by 2. And suppose this point is N, and if N is midpoint of PR, then PN will be equal to RN, and also RM is equal to PR by 2, so this will be equal to RM. PN is equal to RN is equal to RM, and Now, if we join QN, then in triangle PQR, PQ is equal to QR and PN is equal to RN. So this angle will be 90 degree. This angle will be 90 degree. And this angle, it is 60 degree. So this angle, it will be 130 degree, minus 60 degree, minus 35 degree. That is 35 degree. So in triangle R N Q and triangle R M S, angle Q R N is equal to angle S R M, that is 35 degree. And RN is equal to RM and angle RNQ is equal to angle RMS, that is 90 degree. So triangle RNQ, it will be congruent to triangle RMS. Yes. That means RQ will be equal to RS. RQ is equal to RS. And now in triangle QRS, QRS, this angle is 130 degree and this angle is X, and also QR is equal to RS. That means this angle will be also X. So X plus 130 degree, it will be equal to 180 degree. So we get 2X is equal to 50 degree. That means X is equal to 25 degree. And this second method, P, Q, R, S, this angle is 35 degree plus 30 degree, that is 65 degree. This angle is 110 degree. This angle is 130 degree. And suppose this angle is theta, then 110 degree plus 130 degree plus 65 degree plus theta, it will be equal to 360 degree. And 130 degree plus 110 degree is 240 degree, plus 65 degree will be 305 degree, plus theta is equal to 360 degree. So theta will be equal to 360 degree minus 305 degree, that will be 55 degree. and this angle is x, that means this angle, it will be 55 degree minus x. And we have calculated that this angle is 35 degree, that means PQ is equal to QR. We have PQ is equal to QR, so PQ by QS will be equal to QR by QS, and in any triangle ABC and side length ABC, A by sin A is equal to B by sin B is equal to C by sin C. And from here, we can get A by B is equal to sin A by sin B. That means ratio of side length is equal to ratio of opposite angle. So here PQ by QS, it will be equal to sin 55 degree minus x by sin 35 degree plus 30 degree will be 65 degree is equal to, and QR by QS, it will be sin x by sin 130 degree. And sin 2a is equal to 2 sin a cos a. So it is sin 55 degree minus x by sin 65 degree is equal to sin x by sin 130 degree will be 2 sin 65 degree cos 65 degree, and sin 65 degree will get cancelled. So we get sin 55 degree minus x is equal to 1 by 2 times sin x by cos 65 degree. And sin 55 degree minus x times cos 65 degree, it will be equal to 1 by 2 sin x. And cos theta is equal to sin 90 degree minus theta. So it is sin 55 degree minus x times cos 65 degree will be sin 25 degree is equal to, and 1 by 2 is sin 30 degree times sin x. And 2 times sin 55 degree minus x times sin 25 degree will be equal to 2 times sin 30 degree sin x and 2 sin a sin b, it is equal to cos a minus b minus cos a plus b. So this will be equal to cos 55 degree minus x minus 25 degree minus cos 55 degree minus x plus 25 degree is equal to, and this will be cos 30 degree minus x minus cos 30 degree plus x. And it is cos 55 degree minus 25 degree is 30 degree minus x minus cos 55 degree plus 25 degree is 80 degree minus x is equal to cos 30 degree minus x minus cos 30 degree plus x. And cos 30 degree minus x will get cancelled, and we get minus cos 80 degree minus x is equal to minus cos 30 degree plus x, and minus will get cancelled. So cos 80 degree minus x is equal to cos 30 degree plus x. So 80 degree minus x will be equal to 30 degree plus x, and 80 degree minus 30 degree will be equal to x plus x. So we get 2x is equal to 50 degree. That means x is equal to 25 degree.